Inquisitor.
What are they doing here?
Came back. He says you convinced him. Here, for all your trouble.
If we don't talk about it, Mother. If I'm a mage, I have to learn how to live.
Right. That's why. just be dreams. I would love you no matter what, you know that. But it's not safe to be a mage right now.
I know, Mother. I love you too.
Thank you. Inquisitor, I must speak with you.
What is it?
I must explain something first about the Montpellier's fortunes.
I remember you said your family had been forbidden from trading in Orlais.
It's devastated our finances. The Montpelliers have, in fact, been in debt for over 100 years.
I had no idea your family's situation was so precarious.
Hardly anyone outside the family does. For generations, we've done everything to keep creditors at bay. Sold our lands to stave off interest. It's just... it is infuriating to see my family still reduced to this. I'm to become head of our house. If I sell any more of our land, my family will become destitute. That cannot be my legacy to them.
Is there anything I can do?
I'd almost solved our problems. For a while. I negotiated a chance to reinstate the Montpelliers as landed traders in Orlais. We could rebuild with that. But when I dispatched paperwork to Val Royeaux... I've just learned my carriers were murdered. And the documents restoring my family's trading status destroyed.
Do you have any idea who murdered them?
Leliana made inquiries that bore success. Comte Boisvert, a nobleman in Val Royeaux, claims to know who killed my messengers. He has a request. That you come when I meet him, so he's seen publicly conferring with you.
If that's what it takes to get to the bottom of this, I'll meet this Comte with you.
Thank you, Inquisitor. It means... you are too kind. I must know who killed my couriers, just to harm my family.
Inquisitor. Thank you.
disaster is what it is, and you know it.
Theirs were not the only... ...which is affected by the loss of heaven.
The land is only part. The girl has...
Good morrow, La Royal.
I'll appoint a new divine.
Very happy.
And I am the foyer.
Fortuitous reunion.
Closure and good night.
Learned child is a blessing upon his parents and onto the Maker.
Do you know where this noble wanted to meet us?
I do. The Comte Boisvert invited us to his mansion, not far from here. I pray he clears up the deaths of my messengers, as promised.
Lead the way.
Welcome, my friend.
Thank you for seeing us, Comte Boisvert.
The honor is mine. Please, sit. It's an honor to assist two such distinguished guests.
I hope helping us doesn't endanger you.
Hardly. Even a brush with someone as well-known as yourself can become a great asset in Valroyo. Giving you the identity of those who murdered Lady Montilet's messengers seemed the least I could do. Have you heard of the House of Repose?
The Assassins League?
My contacts obtained a copy of a document in the archives. Contract for life.
The House of Repose is hereby sworn to eliminate anyone attempting to overturn the Montilier's trading exile in Orlais.
Overly complicated assassination plots are part of Orlesian politics, I take it.
They're all too common, I'm afraid.
The contract was signed by a noble family. The Duparquets.
But the Duparquets died out as a noble line over 60 years ago.
Indeed. But the contract was signed 109 years ago.
How can a family try to kill you after they died out?
The Duparquets were our rivals. They drove the Montilliers from Val-Royal. This contract was drawn up over 100 years ago, but it wasn't invoked until I tried to overturn my family's exile.
Unpleasant though it may be, the House of Repose is merely fulfilling its contractual duties.
I assume you have a thought or two on this, Josephine.
The Duparquets still have descendants under the common branch. If we elevate them to nobility, a Duparquet could annul the contract on my life.
That will take time, Lady Montigny. Time during which the House of Repose will be obliged to hunt you.
Will they now? You are exceedingly well informed, but not to have said you'd heard rumors at best.
A bit of subterfuge. This contract on your life is an ugly business. One the House of Repose deeply regrets. But this is Orlais. Even an assassin's word is his bond.
I thought you were remarkably well informed about a secret assassin's guild.
We are hardly secret, my dear Inquisitor, just normally much more reclusive. The contract on Lady Montilet's life is so unusual, we felt the courtesy of an explanation was in order.
It is appreciated, monsieur.
Your idea to seek out the Duparquet to revoke our orders is an interesting one. I wish you luck. I did not come to shed blood today, Inquisitor. Only to speak. Might I pass?
Why warn us about your contract and let us go?
In Orlais, it is only decent to inform those involved in a contract when extraordinary circumstances conspire.
And the guild's reputation would suffer if you ignored the contract. I quite understand.
Thank you, my lady. May we conclude with my departure?
Go, then.
Good day, your worship. My lady, I pray we'd never meet again.
Well, I didn't think our meeting would end like this.
We'll deal with these assassins.
I have some thoughts. Let's discuss them back at Skyhold. I'll feel safer with the castle's walls around me.
Do you hear something?
Mm.
Oh, goodness. Comte Poivert, is that you?
Mm.
Oh, the lock's been broken off. We'll find a saw.
Mm.
I realize the cabinet is quite valuable, Comte, but surely... A locksmith, then? As you wish. I'm so sorry, Inquisitor. I never thought my family's trading status would trap us in an assassin's plot.
You couldn't have known it would lead to this House of Repose coming after you.
It still shouldn't have slipped past me. I've tracked down the last Duparquets. If they become gentry, they can annul the contract on my life. We'll require a noble from Val Royaux to sponsor them, a judge to provide documents, a minister to ratify them.
It's so like you to take the longest course of action, even when your life is at stake.
I assume you already know everything about this mess.
There is a faster way, Josephine. The original contract on your life is in the vaults of the House of Repose. If my agents infiltrate it and destroy the original, the assassin will have no obligation to chase you.
Liliana, please. I want no more bloodshed over a personal affair.
Don't be so stubborn, Josie. How long will it take you to gather these favors in Val Royaux?
We can solve this without more deaths on either side.
My people are ready, should you change your mind. I'll post a watch on our ambassador in case the House of Repose visits.
I appreciate it, but I still believe elevating the Duparquets will solve this. First, we need to perform some favors in Val Royaux. I'd be happy to discuss where we could begin. Any news on the House of Repose, Inquisitor?
You said I'd have to do some favors in Val Royaux if we want to make the Duparquets lords.
The Countess Dion is our first step. Her lover, a mage from the White Spire, is missing. Bring her news of him and she'll be very amenable to sponsoring the Duparquets as lords.
Thank you.
Can you arrange what we discussed earlier, Ambassador?
I found the money. The Inquisition will compensate the families of those we lost at Haven.
Thank you.
Stefan finally died. It was a blessing, really. He's been in so much pain since Haven. He was out of his mind at the end. He smiled as he smelled his mother's turnip stew.
Inquisitor, come have a drink. To killing a high dragon like warriors of legend. I know, right? Put some chest on your chest. That little gurgle right before it spat fire. And that roar. What I wouldn't give to roar like that. The way the ground shook when it landed. The smell of the fires burning. Tarsidathan Halsam. You know, Kunari hold dragons sacred. Well, as much as we hold anything sacred. Here, your turn.
That thing you just said. You shouted it during the fight, too. What does it mean?
Oh, Tarsidathan Halsam. Closest translation would be, I will bring myself sexual pleasure later, while thinking about this with great respect.
You shouted that while it was breathing fire at us.
I know, right? Oh. Yes, the second cup's easier. Most of the nerves in your throat are dead after the first one. Atashi, the glorious ones. That's our word for them. Atashi.
Why do you think the Kunari think of dragons that way?
Well, you know how we have horns. We kind of look more dragony than most people. Maybe it's that. But a few of the Ben Hasrath have this crazy old theory. See, the Tamasrans control who we mate with. They breed us for jobs like you'd breed dogs or horses. What if they mixed in some dragon a long time ago? Maybe drinking the blood, maybe magic, I don't know. But something in that dragon we killed spoke to me.
It's a shame we had to kill the dragon.
Damn good fight. Dragons are the embodiment of raw power. But it's all uncontrolled. Savage. So, they need to be destroyed. Taming the wild. Order out of chaos. Have another drink. Oh. Nice! To dragons!
Mm.
to building order out of chaos. Even if it means killing some dragons along the way.
Even if... Especially if...
You sure?
I hear Vachelle was good pay for you, Inquisitor. Time to go see if my friends came through too. Got a location for a stash. Hopefully something nice for my trouble. Well, your trouble. Just let me know when you're ready to head out. Be sure to bring your empty pockets.
I'm ready if you are.
Always, yeah. My favorite part, this. Let's go see what friends can get us. Wait, this is weird.
What?
I was expecting a village or something. The people that leave me stuff don't trek out to places like this. Give me a city and I'll give you a tour, but surprise, surprise, I don't know stupid woods or ruins. What's that?
Don't hurt me. Armand made me do it.
Right. Things have gone sour. As they do.
No! No, it has to go right or he'll kill me for the marching. It wasn't my fault.
You were the one with the rumor out of Vachelle. My friend.
You're her. You're the one he's waiting for. It's her. She's here. Red Jenny.
I was not aware the Inquisitor was personally involved. This is a tragic misunderstanding. Let's all sheathe our swords, you walk out, and we'll conduct this like business.
Don't believe this pissbag. He started it.
There. That wasn't so hard, was it? We identified the confusion, and we worked past it. I'm Lord Pell Harmon. I do hope, Inquisitor, that you continue to respond to reason. After all, your choice of company is hardly virtuous.
Freaking user you are. Another noble prick who punches down.
We're the same, you and I. Well, that is overstating it. You are nothing like me. But we both need people.
You
You want to talk now, but Sarah is my ally. You attacked her friends.
Come now. You know how much her meddling cost me? Because apparently you were complicit. Honestly, previous to this very moment, I thought you'd also been tricked by these red jennies. You're of noble birth, and as Inquisitor, you are more than a peer. I attacked them on behalf of us both.
Arse biscuit.
Quiet. Inquisitor, Herald, I don't want to be your enemy. I'm barely invested in being hers. If you are willing to recognize an opportunity, we could be exceptional partners. Now what was the point of that?
Mother puss bucket friggin' bastard shitebag piss face! Eat it, you lop-eared son of an arse-nut rotten piece of
Sarah!
What?
I think you're done. At this point, you're making wine.
Ugh, that makes it worse. Friends, Inquisitor. Better than his lot any day. Hey, you. Know what? Thanks. Felt good to stomp the smile off that pisshead's face. It doesn't go bad like that often, yeah? But when it does, they deserve it.
Risky, but keep it within the Inquisition and I'll support you.
Even though this puckered around us?
Even so.
Well, good then. Right, what do you mean? Because I am really not used to that acceptance thing you're doing right there.
We'll have some differences, but I want to be one of your friends.
You're pretty big to be one of my contacts. Important, I mean, not fat. But all right, Inquisitor. You're on my good side. We'll see if it lasts. Getting serious about mage stuff. Magic. Things. How about not so much? Just asking for not so much magic. Great, yeah?
Tell me about yourself.
What about me?
How about the basics? Where are you from?
Ferelden.
I got that from the accent. Where in Ferelden?
All over? Okay, fine. Denerim for a bit. South, north, wherever I want.
There are no connections you want to mention at all?
Nope.
How very Kunari of you.
What?
Never mind.
Good, right?
You're skilled. Who taught you how to use a bow?
No one.
That seems unlikely.
What? I picked it up here and there. Mostly, it just makes sense. It's not like that for you.
Usually, it takes considerable discipline. Hence my question.
Hence? Look, I work at it. Practice, a little. Not like Cullen and his pets. I mean, you miss, then you don't. Is it that hard to see when it's wrong?
Is it an elf thing?
Most I know couldn't find an arrow sitting on it. Right. Maybe I just make it look easy in shite company. Fact still is, no teacher. Where would I find one in alleyways, anyway?
You're not like most of the elves I've met.
Thanks, right? Or was that an insult? Suppose I could go barefoot and whine more. Like that Solus, right? never be as good as we were. Well, who's we? I'm just fine.
There's a lot of tradition there. Should it just be thrown away?
Your great-grandfather's dead. Why aren't you dead? You're throwing away tradition.
That makes sense to you.
None of it does in the city. That's why I'm not like an elf.
We'll talk later.
If you say so. You have a problem. That, over there, is a full tavern. But everyone's drinking alone. They're all up their own asses about the Inquisition. I can't have fun with everybody whinging, and they'll fall on their swords before Corypheus can push them. I'm thinking pranks. Set a few up, knock a few down. You in or not?
You have an odd idea of preparation. I need to keep them at their best.
What's best then, Mopey? Constantly ready for death to fall from the gaping hole up there. I know people. Pissed off and fired up is better than dreary bleary. Come on!
Lead the way.
What, really?
Really?
I knew you were different. Let's go. General Uptight is gone. Have a search about. What, the desk? Oh, yes. Center of the Empire and all that. What to do? What to do?
All right, Sarah. What do you want to do?
Thing looks heavy. Don't want to move or break it. I got it. Easy one. Just a slip of something under here. There, won't notice much, but it's just that little bit wonky. He's so in control that'll piss him royally. I tell one of the soldiers and boom, the general seems like people. And since he works for you, you seem like people. Come on, next one. Right, little lady prissy pants. Have a look for something she likes too much. What, just the door? Where she greets every important idiot. Yes!
Well, Sarah, what do you have in mind?
Get a bucket. Classic, yeah? 5 minutes of sloppy boss gets you weeks of happy kitchen staff. Except for the one who cleans it up, I suppose. But whatever. Next up. What's that? A locked... No, leave that. Not interested in her hidden things. Not for just a bit of fun. Maybe feed her messenger something gassy? No, birds don't pop. But they flap and...
Who is up there?
Go!
That was fun. An Inquisitor of the people, still remembering you're one of them. If all they got was the Herald stuff, the serious bit, you'd start to sound pretty scary. That works, but not for long.
Whatever it takes. I'd start throwing pies if it kept people inspired.
Pies is so good! And Corypheus would never do that. Good thing for you, innit? Because from the bottom, everyone up top sort of seems the same. Anyway, fun time, Inquisitor. You! Ulfric! You did it!